minus 1.7 is less than negative 3.2. All right, so we got a number H, minus 1.7, is less than negative 3.2. Aiden?
We'll add 1.7.
We're going to cancel out that negative 1.7. We add 1.7. That leaves us with H on this side. I remember we had a bit of a at-length discussion about the importance of doing the same thing to both sides of an inequality, right? Because even though it's a little off, it's not balanced like equations are. It's unbalanced, right? That is exactly the definition of an inequality. But we want to stay exactly as unbalanced as it started. So we need to do the same thing to both sides so that nothing, you know, gets out of whack at all. So we do the same thing to both sides. That's why we add 4.7 to both sides. We add 1.7 because we want to get this to 0 here, h plus 0. And let's finish it up. Negative 3.2 plus 1.7.
Negative 2.5.
Negative 1.5? Negative 1.5. So h needs to be less than negative 1.5 so that when we take 1.7 away from that number, it'll definitely be less than negative 3.2. All right, so there's a hole in the ground. There it is.
I just looked at the corner. We didn't see anything up there. Do we not have anything?
2 feet. Is that deep? This post needs to be in the ground. 2 feet is how deep the post needs to be in the ground. So the post is
down in there.
Then the part that sticks up needs to be 4 feet at least, right? Mm-hmm. So there's got to be at least, like, let's say that much of it is 4 feet. Now, it could be exactly 4 feet, or it can go beyond the 4 feet, but it can't be less than that. And when I did this with the other class, I called this X, but then I decided that doesn't fit the question, because the question asks, write and solve an inequality that represents the required length of the fence post, like the whole fence post. All right. So in this diagram, the whole fence post would be this guy right here, like this length. That's what we're looking for. That is X. That's our thing that can vary. It can be one thing, it can be another thing. It's variable. So, no, this one's almost too easy. But can we write an inequality that we have to at least do one thing to solve it? Rather than saying that just x needs to be greater than or equal to. Right. Can we write an inequality that needs to be solved and that the solution is it's x needs to be greater than or equal to 6? Let's take the statement that we read in the problem. It says that the leftover, the part that's above the ground, needs to be at least 4. Okay? Right. So, at least 4. How do we say that something is at least 4 with inequalities?
The bar.
Okay, we need the bar, right? Because it could be 4.
Go ahead.
Goes like this.
Yeah.
The thing, right? The fence post or this part right here needs to be at least 4. It needs to be greater than or equal to 4. Okay? And so how do we get this?
X minus 2.
Like I said, I know this is an easy one. I know it's easy to see that it at least has to, like, the whole fence post got to be at least 6, right? But in some way in your head, you're doing something like this. You're saying, well, there's the 2 and the 4. So how do we solve this inequality?
Plus 2.
Add 2 to both sides. We get x is greater than or equal to 6. Something that maybe you could just see by looking at this diagram. The fence post minus the two that's underneath the ground gives me the leftover that's above the ground, and that needs to be at least four. And we figure out the whole post needs to be at least six. So when you go to Home Depot and you're picking out fence posts, you're going to be measuring them and make sure they measure at least 6 feet. Okay, so that was 24.2, now 3.3. 19. So I'm just going to write down exactly what this little blue rectangle has and see if we can figure out what the mistake was. Right, so they multiply by 2 on both sides, it looks like. This 2 times negative 5, because there's a negative 5 over there. And so x is greater than negative 1. So they had this problem, x divided by 2 is less than negative 5. They multiplied by 2 on both sides. That canceled the 2, I was left 6 there. 2 times negative 5 is negative 10. So what's the problem? They switched what?
The sign.
It's that way.
It's like that, and they made it point the other way.
Yeah.
That's not right.
Oh.
It should be this. It should have just stayed.
Yeah.
Now, why do you think this person made that mistake? Like, what's going on in their heads that they made that mistake?
Because they thought it was a negative. It's a negative 10 over there, so it probably thought it was a negative, so they had to flip the sign.
There's that negative, right? They multiplied by a negative 5.
Mm-hmm.
So they, in their heads, they were thinking like some kind of a part of a statement was in their head, something like, They were hearing their teacher say, whenever you multiply by a negative, right? Whenever you multiply by a negative, you have to flip the sign. Did they multiply by a negative?
No.
Yeah.
Did. There was a negative involved in a multiplication problem. But they kind of missed the last part of this. What's the last part of this statement that they kind of forgot, Sarah?
On both sides.
Sides, like when that is the step that you take to solve the inequality, that's when you flip the sign. So they forgot the last little bit, which was when you multiply by negative on both sides, which they didn't do. They multiplied by a positive 2. Okay. It's a common mistake. It happens quite a bit. I bet that they did. No, that would be bad. And 38. Nice little picture here.
Spend his money on this thing. We can afford.
Don't. It's a Peter though.
What is that?
It's a company that makes semis.
This is like rods.
That's a 3-tire truck. It's gonna fall over.
No, it's got 6
tires.
You just can't see the other 3.
There. It's a great picture. And it's got a crate on it. It says the crate is 28 inches tall. It says the height of this thing is 3.5 feet. So right off, just from looking at the diagram, can you see something that needs to happen?
Yes.
What needs to happen here?
Make inequality. I don't know.
Clint, just from looking at the diagram?
X times 20, oh, you have to take 28 inches times 5.
Wait. Just from looking at this diagram.
Divided by 12.
Divide this by 12?
Yeah, you could do that.
Why are we doing that?
Because you need it in feet, not inches.
Right, we need them in feet, or both in feet or both in inches, and it says feet, so let's make it feet. So that's 2 1/3 feet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's better. Now we're comparing apples to apples, feet to feet.
That didn't
happen.
So one crate is 2 1/3 feet tall. They're saying they're stacking 5 crates. And in, what does it say? Does it name the state? Does it say a certain state? Or in a lot of states? In many states, the total height of your truck can only be 13.5 feet. Why would they care how tall your truck is?
For tunnels.
Tunnels.
Like, hard to go underneath, and you don't like
see my roof lights and all.
That'd be a good idea. We don't wanna like knock the crates off of this thing and then it falls off into the road and crash into it, it'd be bad. So there's this 13.5 feet maximum that any truck can be. So maybe let's start with an inequality with that, because when it says like at most or can't be more than or no less than or whatever, let's start with that. So 13.5 feet, right? My truck needs to have some relation to 13.5 feet. Aiden?
So
So less than or equal to 13.5 feet, because it says that the maximum height including freight of a vehicle is 13.5 feet, the maximum, right? Max, the most, right? So it's on the larger end. This 13.5 is the biggest that it could be, and everything else needs to be less than that. So all trucks need to be less than 13.5 feet. All right, so now we gotta calculate.
Just make
the
calculation.
I'm just wondering, is that like the actual law?
What?
Well, I don't know, but I want to believe that whoever wrote this book
is smart
somewhere. But I don't know. I don't know if that. I don't know what they mean by many. I don't know if that's the actual number. But I mean, it's certainly.
Seems realistic.
Not that hard.
I bet that's
up.
Not a law in Montana, though. We don't care.
Montana, we don't care. Spill your freight all over the
place. Yeah. And then people steal it.
Alright, so. Whatever the height of the truck is, it needs to be less than 13.5 feet, so we need to calculate the height of this truck. It says, we need to write and solve an inequality based on that.
The height of this
3.5. One crate is 2 1/3 feet. Right. So I guess, actually, this is for a little bit later, because all they're asking us now is, can we put 5 crates?
Nope.
How do you figure out?
You take 2 1/3 times 5.
2 1/3 times 5. Plus
3.5. And that equals less than 13.
Only less than or equal to
13.5. And then you solve it and see if the equation is true.
Inequality.
Oh, inequality.
Not equation, sorry. Let's see, 3.5. That's 10 and let's see, 10 and 5/3, 11 and 2/3, plus 3.5. I take 11 and 2/3, and let's just add 3 to 11 and 2/3. Where are we at then? Just add the 3 from this to 11 and 2/3.
We're
already at 14, right?
Yeah.
If I add 3 feet to this, I'm at 14, which is already too high. And then if I add the 0.5, then yeah, it's too high. So no. So part A, no, it's definitely too tall. It doesn't matter how much too tall, it's too tall. So let's write this inequality for any number of crates. Okay. So if I have X crates, how do I calculate the height of a truck that has X crates on it?
You go 3.5 plus 2 1/3 x equal to or less than 13.5.
All right, there we go. Mm-hmm. Less than 13.5. And we solve for x.
Work.
I don't know what.
Yeah.
So 2 1/3 times x plus 3.5 equal or less than or equal to 13.
Minus 3.5.
Good.
Get you to
10. I get you to 10.
Divide.
Let's write this as 7/3.
Divide by 7/3. Oh no, then you multiply by the reciprocal.
Remembering that. That's great.
I don't know. Sometimes 3 equals 30 over 7.
You got 30 over 7.
Which would you get about 4 point something.
So that's about 4.8.
821.
Doesn't
it
even matter. The question is, how many crates can we put on here?
4. Which is 4.
4. So we really need x to be less than or equal to 4 crates.
4.821838. Calculated that perfectly.
So 4 crates. That's how many you can put. Or less, but no more.
45 out of 40, that is more than a half.
Okay, any questions?
Go
good? Add both sides, subtract from both sides, multiply both sides, divide both sides, multiply both sides by the reciprocal.
Yep.
And what's the one? Like, this is all the same as solving equations. Nothing really new here. Except for what's the one tiny catch for solving inequalities? That's the same as equations.
You have to flip
when
them
when times or dividing by a negative number, you have to flip the sign thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. Okay, sounds good. Sounds like we're ready. So let's put everything away except for a piece of paper. And
ready.
Alright. So, how do we solve this first inequality?
Minus 3
on both sides, you're going to get x is less than or equal to 7.
Yep.
Yeah.
Seven
plus
right.
Plus 6.
Add 6. Greater than 9.
And
yeah.
Then you have to flip flop the.
That's only multiply or divide by a negative?
Oh,
divide by
a
negative.
I got 3 on that. You get 2 for trying though, right?
Yeah, 2 or 3 is equal.
Okay. So you divide by 2/3, no, you times by 3.
Times by 3/2.
Times by 3/2, because you get 6/6, which is 1, and that's good.
Which equals
1
12.
Is
Tyler,
4 8.
Walk me through what I'm doing.
Put the root on the top, times it by 3.
Times by 3, you have?
Over 2.
What is it?
24/2.
Okay, so x is less than 24/2.
You can simplify it.
To what?
12.
X is less than 12. Next.
And then you
Tyler.
Have to divide by negative 8.
Divide by
negative
8.
Negative 8. Yeah,
negative
flip, 8. Flip this sign around.
Good.
It's that to -1.4.
Negative, I will
say -3/2, but yes, negative.
It's equivalent to -3/2. I feel bad fractions. Everybody treats them like a pariah.
I'm going to copy this down.
Pariah.
What's that?
Tomorrow.